All right, welcome to the second stream about Azure Cloud. And this time we are trying to do some of the things we did last time. And then we are going to jump over to setting up an actual development Minecraft server and trying to access that one with IntelliJ. So the idea here is that you can much quicker test out new ideas and features in Minecraft if you have a direct connection to the server. And you can then change code in IntelliJ, and that will directly affect the gameplay without rebooting the server or sending and uploading a new file or something, right? So this is what we are trying to achieve this time. First step, I guess, is to quickly show you what we did before. So you just click on start free account, and then you can see here you will get $200 of free Azure credit. After you have set that up, you are gonna get into this view here. And last time we created a virtual machine. We're just gonna create a new Ubuntu server. Then we use all the defaults here in this one, for example. Then we are just gonna go with the server idle head last time. We are gonna say again, I just want a normal password here. Then the only important thing is that there is at least this SSH port available. Otherwise we cannot connect to the server, right? And that's pretty much it. So the idea of this was just to show you it can be much, much easier than last time, right? if you didn't done this once, the next time is much, much easier. Now the server is being deployed for us. This should take maybe a minute or something. While this is happening in the background, we can already go to the next step because we want to create a Minecraft server, right? And we want to set up a plugin on this. You can see here, they are just setting up a normal project. All you need to do then after this has been set up is you have this go to resource, and then you get into the normal view of the server. Create a connection to the server. And for that, we'll need to know the IP address so we can connect to it. And that is shown over here. So this is the IP address that I need. So let me quickly set up that. We just need to create a new, and you can see you are connected then to the given server, and then you just need to provide the password, and that should now give you access. That's pretty much it. Now you have a running server, and you can not only install obviously Minecraft on this, but you could host your website and stuff on that and run Nginx and things like that. Okay, and then the next thing here we can see, we need some kind of Java version to be able to start a Java in Minecraft instance, right? So this is done now, Java --- version, and we can see this is now 17.0.1, and that's the same that I have locally installed. To the next step, right? We said we need a blank Spigot plugin. We need to set up something for that. So all we need to do for that is we need to go into IntelliJ and we say then, for example, new project. And in my case, I want to have a Maven project. Now we need a name for that. Let's go into development Azure, and then let's call it tutorial. Now we have a new project. You can see here there are some defaults set up. The first thing we need to do is follow some of the instructions that we had in the tutorial here. We are going to wait for this to finish. So what we need to do now is we are building this bigger jar on the server, but we need that on the local computer, right? Because we want to develop the plugin locally, and then we want to upload that to the server once. And after that, we kind of want to use the hot swapping functionality if possible. Wait for this here to quickly finish. And then after that has finished, we want to download the files from the server to our local machine. And we are done now. Okay, so let me try the same command with this one. Let's see what happens then. We have this part, so we can close this for now, and we can go back to the tutorial thing, and we'll see that the only thing that they do is basically create a new package, and then in that they create their first Java file. So now the next part is that this file cannot yet be found by Spigot. We need to make sure that it can be found by Spigot, and for that we need to provide a plugin YAML file. We are gonna go on the source folder, new, create a, what's that, text file. Path was DE, and then this, and then the plugin name. We should be able to create a jar file out of this, right? This building gives us then a small jar file here. And this jar file is basically like a zip file, right? So what we can do, we can actually look into that zip file. We can see this is what it looks internally. We have our plugin YAML, And then we also have the file that is being referenced in here. So that should be working. And now we should have our second version of our plugin running on the server as soon as this boots up. And we can quickly test if the command works. Now let's just write a test. We can see in the console already, command is working, right? Then let us also do the same with a Minecraft client to make sure that works. And we are going to say we need the IP address of our new Azure testing server. And that was over here. Okay, that works already. And if I now type test, we can see it tells us, I'm sorry, but you have no permission to use that command, right? So I'm not allowed to use that command. We should be able to get around this by making me an op in Minecraft. That is the admin rank in Minecraft. Now I can write test. We can't see any outputs, right? It does tell us we executed that, but it doesn't give us output because that output is only the console. It still works, even though we are in the game. So what we can do now is we can start connecting to the server, right? And for that, we only need the IP address again from our current server. In IntelliJ, we go up here to the run configuration. And in the run configuration, we want to have a remote and then the address in this case, I define here as a local address. To create a tunnel to a given server, all you need to do, you don't even need this port thing here, you just say SSH, tunnel should be on our local machine on port 5008, also on the remote machine on 5008. We could change this to any other thing, right? They don't need. And then we need to provide the server that we want to connect to so that we can again, obviously look up in here. That is our IP address. And now it asks us again about the password because we need to authenticate ourselves. So now you can see we are connected. Address already in use. Well then, that did not work. let's exit. Let's just check 5009 maybe. We don't have these error messages. We should be connected with that. And now we have a connection from our local machine to the Azure Cloud server. And that should allow us now to connect to that. We can set this up. This is remote hot swap. And now we should just be able to say we want to connect to the server. And now we can start changing our Minecraft server on the fly. Now we can actually say, this is a parameter here. We can accept the parameter. So now we can actually return this the length of the input, right? We could say input.length. And then we need to make sure that our system doesn't break if that is null or something. Okay, save this, hot swap. Go back to the server console and type in the command again. And we can see we get a length of 4. And now we can just change this, right? We can say length of, I don't know, S. So this is super awesome, right? We can, instead of needing to reboot and re-upload every single change that we do, we can do that on the fly now. All right, now we have the player object, and now we can do some simple operations on the player directly. We could say the test command should now, instead of just typing something, it should actually do something to the player object, right? In this case, we can say, for example, player and then set velocity, and that is the current speed that we have in a given direction. We want that to be a new vector. This would tell the system now that this specific player should be moving up into the air. Now, if we save that, we hot swap this again, we go back into the Minecraft client and we type in the same command, we jump pretty high to our death maybe even. But now we basically have a super jump command and we didn't even need to reboot the server, right? This is super awesome. We can just do that while the system is running and we can test out new ideas. We are good for today and thank you for watching and participating.